Good morning, everybody. This is Sean Copeland. Today is Saturday, February the 25th, and welcome to another life-changing edition of the Kingdom Driven CEO. Today on the Kingdom Driven CEO, we have an awesome topic, and it comes from a new book that I recently read slash listened to called The Gap and the Gain. And I am telling you, if you are an achiever, which most of our listeners are, and if you struggle with happiness, which many of us do, I think this could be the game changer for you. And as I jump into the topic, I just want to remind you that that Jesus said that he came so that we could have life and have it more abundantly, okay? And he tells us over and over in the Word that we should be grateful, that we should, it says, even in our prayers, it says, bring our prayers to him with thanksgiving, that everything we do should be with thanksgiving. But we struggle with this, and I want to talk to you a little bit about why, and I want to talk to you about the gap and the gain. The gap refers to the space between where you currently are and where you want to be. The gain, on the other hand, refers to the progress you make towards your goals. The gap and the gain are kind of two sides of the same coin. They're inseparable and they're essential to achieving our dreams. But the problem is we tend to focus on the gap, and we all have gaps in our lives. We don't focus on the gain, the progress that we are making in our lives. So I'm going to talk to you about this, and I'm going to give you some strategies around how to change the way we view our lives. This is absolutely critical. We all have gaps. We all have areas where we fall short. It might be a career goal we haven't reached, a relationship that hadn't worked out. It might be a skill we want to master, but we don't feel like we're making enough progress. Whatever the gap is, it can be discouraging, demotivating, debilitating. It can make us feel like giving up. But the gap is not the enemy. It's an opportunity. It's a chance to grow, to learn, and to improve. The gap is where the magic happens. It's where we discover our strengths, our weaknesses, and our true potential. It's where we learn to push ourselves beyond our limits and to reach for the stars. The gain is the progress, we make toward closing the gap. It's the steps that we take toward our goals, the milestones that we reach, and the achievements that we earn. The gain is what keeps us going. It's what gives us the momentum to move forward, even when the going gets tough. The gain is the proof that we're on the right track, that we're making progress, and that we're getting closer to our dreams. But the gain is not the destination. It's just a step along the way. The gain is a reminder that we're moving in the right direction, but it is not the end goal. The end goal is the place where the gap no longer exists, where we've achieved everything we've set out to do. And the problem is that will never happen. Okay? This is the issue. We tend to measure ourselves against the ideal. Okay, we look at our lives and we go, okay, it's pretty good. You know, we've had some success. We live in a nice home. We drive a nice car. We have employees. You know, we're making ends meet, but we're not where we want to be because we measure against the ideal. This is impossible. This is the key to what I want us to understand today. By definition, the ideal is perfection, and we are never going to be in a situation where everything in our lives is exactly perfect. That is never going to happen. That is why we have to focus on the gain and not the gap. And we're going to talk about this as we go through our conversation today. Thomas Jefferson, in the Declaration of Independence, even talked about life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. He didn't talk about happiness. He talked about the pursuit of happiness. We started out with a gap. It's like that's how America is built around a gap. It's also why we buy so much stuff, because we're trying to fill some unmet need that marketers are creating for us. And this makes happiness seem impossible to achieve because we're just trying to pursue it. CEOs tend to live in the gap. We're twice as likely to live in depression. We struggle with substance abuse. We struggle with suicide. Even though they are viewed with envy by others, they don't feel happy, because as soon as they experience a victory, our minds immediately go to the next unreached achievement. This can lead to great accomplishment, external accomplishment, no doubt, but no happiness or gratitude. And I know this is resonating with you because it resonated with me. CEOs never value our progress because it's never as good as it could have been. We have to look at the progress we have made and not compare to the ideal. The problem is the horizon is always moving in the distance. This is called the Adonis adaptation. It means we're always adjusting to our current situation and moving the goal out so we never get there. We're not taught how to be happy. Goals are met, but we are constantly adjusting our measure against a future goal so we are not happy. We're measuring ourselves against our ideals, which are unreachable by definition. We have to learn to measure backwards. We have to learn to measure our progress from some point in time. That point in time is whatever you choose. I had a wonderful experience this week. We had our board meeting, we had our annual shareholder meeting, and we had our client VIP party. So every year, on the third Thursday in February, everybody comes together and we talk about our progress. And one thing that we do during this time is we go back to the very beginning of the bank, when Regent Bank was losing money and about to go under. And then we bring it forward to today, where we made $13.5 million last year, and we're a $1 billion organization, and we're one of the top regional banks in our area. And we appreciate what the Lord has given us. We measure backwards instead of measuring forwards. Now, then we talk about what are our goals, and it's healthy to have goals. Nobody is saying that. We just don't want to constantly measure versus the future versus the ideal. The gain is about actions and results, not what we could have or should have completed or what could have or should have happened. That's got to go away. We can even take mistakes and traumatic experiences and turn them into a gain by looking at what we learned during that experience. We can actually reframe our traumatic experiences by turning them into learnings. What did I learn? And then you move away from that and move forward and leave that behind. The problem is that people tend to have a lot of experience, but very little learning. We have to learn to become better from our past and not bitter. Our progress, when we can do this, our progress will be shocking to outsiders, because everyone else allows failure to paralyze them, but with us, it will become just another learning. We can place others in the gap as well by comparing them to who we think they should be and to their ideal, and not looking at their progress and growth. We have to be careful about putting our children in the gap. If they don't think we approve of them now and we're always comparing them to the ideal, it can be catastrophic. Suicide tends to occur in the brightest of kids because they can't ever figure out how they're going to close the gap, because largely they have a parent that's constantly comparing them to the ideal. Same thing with our employees. It's important for them to have goals I'm a huge goal setter, but it is important that we measure their progress and praise their progress as well. Dan Jansen turned things around in the Olympics. I don't know if you all remember, he was the greatest speed skater, and he went into the Olympics and had just an awful Olympics. And in the last race, he switched his thinking to the gain, and he got away from the gap, and he thought about all of his accomplishments and the wonderful career he had had and all the people that supported him. And what happened? He won his final race because he got out of the gap and he got into the game. We can't rely on something outside of our control to make us happy. You know, it can't be money, can't be what somebody else has. We have to focus on our progress to make us happy. You know, Trevor Lawrence had a really interesting experience recently where he made a quote and he said, I don't need football. I don't value myself based upon football. He is a very faith-based and spiritual person. And he said, I value myself based upon my relationship with God. And everybody went bananas because nobody understands the fact that we can have both success, and we can have a healthy detachment from what we are doing and get our value elsewhere. That is living in the gain. He is not holding himself to some ridiculous standard where, you know, he's going to kill himself for a game that he knows does not define him. The key is to run our race. Tom Brady is a really good example. Tom Brady took 60% of the pay that he could have as a quarterback. And what did he do? He took the remainder of that pay and invested it, if you will, into second string offensive linemen, because he knew that late in the year, when offensive linemen were getting hurt and injured, the best quarterback has the best offensive line, and the second string offensive lineman would continue to help him be protected and do well as a quarterback. It's like this whole thing is kind of like the movie It's a Wonderful Life, where George Bailey, if you've ever seen it, it's one of my favorites, where he gets really down on his luck. He wishes he had never been born. Clarence the Angel comes along and shows him what his life would be like had he never been born. And suddenly, he begins to realize the difference that he has made, the progress that he has made, the change that he has made all around him. So let me give you three strategies as we close today to live in the gain and not in the gap. Number one is to develop a win streak. So every day, and these are from Dan Sullivan, I love them. I'm practicing these right now. List three wins that you had today. And this is all at the end of the day. List three wins today and then visualize three wins for tomorrow. And the beauty of this is we are focusing on our progress. We are all growing, and we begin to have wins all the time. What we're thinking about are our wins. We put aside where the day might have been rough, the challenges, and we focus on the three wins for today that we had and the three wins we expect to have tomorrow. And all this happens in strategy number two, which is the most important hour of the day. I always thought it was the first hour of the day because I'm a big morning person, as you know. He says it is the last hour of the day. It can be a gain hour. It can set the tone for our life, but we have to have a clear and committed plan for that last hour. Number one, don't use our smartphone. Put away social media. The worst thing we can do is look at a bunch of snapshots from the best of everybody's life before we go to bed. That puts us in the gap. We start to believe we're not as good as them. Look at the vacation they went on. Look how beautiful they are. That's the worst thing we can do. Put it away. It hurts our sleep and it hurts our identity. Think about two things before we go to bed. One, the three wins we had that day. Two, the three wins we're going to have tomorrow. Three, the biggest opportunity or challenge that we are trying to solve. And then go to sleep and allow our subconscious to work. It will build us up. It will help us feel better. It will help us solve our problems. This way, we are always winning. We're getting 21 wins per week, and we can retrain our attention and our focus. We go to bed happy and confident. We wake up excited and focused. And our wins, frankly, can even be learnings. If we had something bad happen, we can reframe it into a learning. Then finally, start and end every meeting with a positive focus. When we began, you know, let's go around and say, hey, let's talk about a win that you've had since we last met. Just get things on a positive. When we end, let's talk about one thing we've learned in this meeting, to where everything becomes about wins and becomes about positive things. Happiness is not something we pursue because ideals become something we can never achieve. But if we can change this in our mind and stop looking at the horizon in the future that's always moving, stop looking at that ideal that's always moving out from us, and begin to measure from the past, measure from before, measure our progress, focus on wins, we can change our mindset to where we are focused on the gain and not on the gap. So I hope this changes your life the way it is changing mine. I'm so happy you joined us today on the Kingdom Driven CEO, and I hope you'll be back with us next Saturday, where we always have new content by noon every Saturday morning. Thank you so much, and I have a wonderful week. The heart is a